1976, Part 1. Tonight, featuring the dynamic Napoleon Murphy Brock on tenor sax and Lee Bumble. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Little skinny Terrence Ed Bozio on drums. Roy Ralph Mulvan Guacamole Estrada on bass. And yours truly, Todd Rundgren on guitar. In the dark, where all the fevers grow, under the water, where the shark bubbles blow, in the morning, by your radio, do the walls close in to suffocate you? You ain't got no friends, and all the others, they hate you. There's a life you've been leading, gotta go. Well, let me straighten you out. I know. Get your shoes and socks on, people, cause it's right around the corner.
Thank you.
thereafter, God made a poodle. When God first made the poodle, it had hair evenly distributed all over its charming, small, canine sort of a body. It looked pretty good. All the rest of the dogs respected it because it was one of the bunch. Now, let me repeat a little bit of my story. In the beginning, God made the light, as you all know, and then God made the poodle. Well, about 15 minutes later, God made two big mistakes. One of them was called Man, and the other one was called Woo-Man. Woo-Man looketh upon the poodle. Studieth the poodle, and turneth to man, and saith unto man these very words, Sucker, go get a job, whereby you mayest bring unto me, along with your ridiculous little paycheck, you miserable, wretched sort of a person, along with that paycheck, bring unto me a pair of scissors with which I may modify the aforementioned poodle. And the man, being the chump that he was, went forth into the world and got himself a job, and got himself a paycheck, and took part of his paycheck and bought for the wool man a pair of scissors, which he brought back to the cave where they were living. The wool man graspeth upon the scissors, and graspeth upon the poodle, and clippeth upon the poodle in these important areas. The tootsies, the thorax, the managua, and the medulla oblongata, gradually working around to the snout, as they call it in the trade, leaving just a little beaver-like appurtenance near the poodle chops. And then Woo Man putteth aside her clipping device and setteth up the poodle in a quasi-erotic position, thusly. Now, because our poodle demonstration model is rather small and the lights are not exactly Radio City Music Hall around here, I'll show you how the poodle is supposedly sitting. Hey! The poodle is sitting there like this. Whereupon the woo man gazeth deep into the eyes of the aforementioned poodle and put her legs upward toward heaven in a gesture of supplication thusly, and saith unto the poodle these words, which you may, we will allow you to cherish these words for the rest of your natural life.
I don't need your cheap emotion. Give me up some back emotion. I want a little more.
go into another number that sort of carries the conceptual continuity of poodle ravaging to an ultimate degree of absurdity. This song is so absurd it doesn't have any words to it all. It's called Filthy Habits. Thank you. Atkins.
Thank you.
baby, don't you want my bad night? Oh, baby, don't you want my bad night? He was the playboy type, he smoked a pipe. His favorite phrase was on the side. He had an Irish head. Was a singles bar on Tuesday night. The moon was dim, the band was tied. They did the bop together. Sword, all a little too short. Her jokes were dumb, and her favorite sport was hockey in the winter. He was duly impressed, and was quick to suggest any sport with a pop had to be about the best as he jabbed his elbow in her. Off they went off to where the music was soft. The candles were dreaming. They saw a real hippie. He took her home to a motor car. She wouldn't kiss him. He tried to ignore it, but it made him angry. He called him a slut, a pig and a whore, a bitch and a cunt, and she slammed the door in a petulant frenzy. So he has to use the phone, and she gives him some head. Some of you, anyway. This is the true story of the Illinois Enema Bandit, one of the great Americans of the 20th century. Now, I don't know what you get to read in the papers over here about what's going on in the US of A. I'm sure they never tell you the good stuff. So we're here to do our part for international goodwill by letting you know about the busy little doings of a gentleman whose real name is Michael Kenyon. Michael Kenyon, for the last 10 years, has been ravaging certain parts of the USA with a special little box that he carries around with him. He's got a briefcase. In the briefcase is a ski mask, some newspaper, a rope, thermometer, pistol, and an enema bag, or a NEMA bag, like you say it down here. NEMA! Anyway, Michael was really a card. He would burst into the homes of college-educated women and, at gunpoint, force them to submit to some sort of cosmically oriented internal rinse procedure. He would take out his thermometer and his rope, and he'd tie them up, make them lay down on their tummy, and pushing apart the gluteus maximus, he would take his little thermometer and
do it,
pull it out, give it a quick whiff and a read, put it back in its sterile little container, put it back into the briefcase, and then dash away into the commode, where he would fill the bag with hot water. Then he would dash back into the room, where the college co-ed was all bound down, and he would take the nozzle of this mysterious device and ram that sucker right on up her butt, and pump her up with about 2 quarts of tap water. Then he would beat his meat, or have himself a wank, as you say in the trade, and tell the poor young girl not to call the police for at least 5 minutes after he had left. And then the ugly ones he would rob. Well, that's the breaks. They caught him, ladies and gentlemen. He has been caught. He has been brought to justice. He was arrested, tried and convicted and sentenced to a bunch of years, I don't know how many, maybe 20 or something like that, for 5 counts of armed robbery, because apparently there is no law against giving a college-educated woman an enema. And so, whoops, here it is. Sing along if you like. The DA will order a secret test and stuff his pudgy little thumbs in the side of his vest. Pull out a call.
And the jury votes.
That's you. And then the judge would say, no poo-poo jokes. Well, Drag and the Bandit are all to see saying, don't nobody know who happens to pay. I'm so be one off in the first degree, whereupon the bandit might say, Wind up working in the gas station. I'm on the gas every night. I'm on the gas every night. Wind up working in the gas station. I'm on the gas every night. eyes all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. Prisoners grumble and kiss their clothes, scratch their matted hair. A tiny light from a window hole 100 yards away is all they ever get to know about the regular life in the day. And it stinks so bad, the snow's been choking in the room where the giant fire put the works, and the torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. The torture never stopped. Slime and rot, rats and snot, vomit on the floor. And 50 Union soldiers manned with spears by the iron door. Knives and spikes and guns and the likes of every tool of pain. And a sinister fidget with a bucket and a mop where the snot goes down the drain. And it stinks so bad, the stone's been choking with greenish drops in the room where the giant fire puffer works. And the torture never stops. In his dungeon of despair, an evil prince eats a steaming pig in a chamber right near there. He eats the snouts and the trotters first, the lloyds and the groins is soon dispersed. His carving style is well rehearsed. flies all green and buzzing in his dungeon of despair. Who are all those people that he's locked away down there? Are they crazy? Are they fainters? Are they heroes? Someone made it. Never been explained since at first it was created. For the
Thank you.
vocals. Andre Lewis on keyboards. Both skinny Terry Bozio. Terry said Bozio on drums and lead vocals. Roy Scott on bass. Ralph Humphrey on guitar. sister was in Paul's equivalent way. And clutched at herself. Her sister made a joke about mental health till her whole body didn't give in. But I told her all she really needed was some discipline. I said, kiss my aura.
Aura.
And she was beating a drum, but she loved the band. She had a game.
born to have adventure, you see. So I just followed up the steps, right past the fuming incense stencher, to where she hung a castanet. She stripped away her rancid poncho, made out naked by the door. We did it till we were unconcho, and it was useless anymore. She had a snake full of men, and a man who left, and she was beating a woo! But she wasn't done yet. She had gray skin, and I was a pin in the pool of shame with my life, but I couldn't come in. And so she wandered through the dark, like a shadow from the tomb. She said a stereo was falling. I just love it in the room. Well, I was born to have adventure. Was a muffin.
Thank you.
rule and regulate you. I might be vile and pernicious, but you can't look away. I make you think I'm delicious with the stuff that I say. Oh, I'm the best you can get. Have you guessed me yet? I'm the slime oozing out from your TV set. You will obey me while I leave you and eat the garbage that I feed you until the day that we don't need you. Don't go for help, no one will heed you. Your mind is totally controlled. It has been to my mold, and you will do as you are told until the light that you are. thank you very much for coming to the concert. Hope you enjoyed it. You're a very wonderful audience.